There's a young woman. She's 17 years young, and the year is 1996. She's filled with jubilation and trepidation. It's her first day of her BA in dance. She's going to make her way into the dance studio and try to achieve something that might not be possible. Her dream of becoming a performing artist, of traveling around the world and feeling at home in the theatre, of having a career as a dancer. Her name is Yolande Brown. My name is Yolande Brown. I've been given the opportunity to send a message back to my younger self. Something she should know about is criticism, because it's going to be a big part of her future as a student and as a professional artist. Criticism is going to be like tough love. It's going to be a friend, a key to unlock the potential that lies ahead. There are going to be times where she's the only person who believes that she can achieve what she wants to achieve. I guess the next message I could consider would be to let her know not to be afraid of pain. You're going to have a sore back, you're going to have sore feet, a pulled hamstring, but all these aches and pains are part of the journey of learning about your weaknesses and how to strengthen your body. You'll be able to train harder, push through things, and oh yeah, maybe I should let her know about when she breaks her foot, that this isn't going to be the end of her career, that she just needs a bit of time out to reconsider her priorities and realise that it is really being on stage that she wants to do. With 20 years of retrospect, you start to think that time is really significant. Nothing really beats a good yarn with family. All the Google searches in the world won't bring that back. I think the ultimate message I would want to send back to my younger self would be, sit with your elders, to put your dancing shoes up and sit next to your grandparents. See if that young Yolande can learn through her grandmother's eyes about her great-grandmother and about her Bidjara culture, the traditional culture that was really important and rich before assimilation became the dominant journey. Your future is going to be storytelling. So sit back and listen to the stories that have paved the way to you. So 19 years have passed since that young dancer first stepped foot into the dance studio with her dreams ahead of her. And it feels pretty amazing to have achieved a lot of those dreams. I've danced all over the world. So what would my younger self think about all the experiences that I've had over the last 19 years? I think she'd be pretty gobsmacked, really. This has been a really interesting task for me because it's made me reflect upon who I was all of those 19 years ago. It was a turning point in her life, and all of these years later, I guess I'm reaching a new turning point. 16 years of a dance career is a long time, and how long am I going to keep dancing for? Reflecting back on who this young girl was, I guess has helped me realise I have the strength to create my future, whatever it's going to be. I still have that thick skin, I still have that toughness, and she's still inside of me, she's still strong, and she's able to guide my future footsteps into the next part of my journey.